Brought to you by Lucas Oil, made in America, sold to the world. Welcome back to the Lake of the Torches Resort Casino. This is King of the Cage from Lac du Flambeau, Wisconsin. As we take a quick look at our tale of the tape. Both fighters in the super heavyweight division. With his 265 plus in this weight class, 80-inch reach advantage. Before we get to this fight, we'll go into Nate Stone.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Lake of the Torches Resort Casino, Lac du Flambeau, Wisconsin, King of the Cage and Lucas Oil present this special three-round bout in the super heavyweight division. The referee in charge of the action, Sensei Cecil Peebles. Introducing first, in the Lucas Oil blue corner, standing 6'4" tall. Official weight, 265 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, from South Beloit, Illinois, presenting Tyler the Riot Reese. His opponent across the cage, fighting out of the Lucas Oil red corner, stands at 5'10" tall. Official weight, 287 pounds. He represents Oshkosh, Wisconsin. Ladies and gentlemen, from Green Lake County, Wisconsin, presenting Eric the House Allen. Once again, your referee in charge, Sensei Cecil Peebles, for the final instructions. Three rounds of super heavyweight action skin.
And here we go, the super heavyweight division between Tyler Reese and Eric Allen. And here we go.
We've talked about the lighter weights, and we've talked about the heavier weights and the difference in between them. And it's, the difference is one of these punches can end the fight.
Seconds into this, both fighters are already engaging, and Eric Allen just looks to take this to the ground.
Yeah, I do not think Eric Allen wants to stay on the fight right here, because he has such a disadvantage on the feet, I believe. You know, between the height and reach, the distance is a huge issue there.
And here is Porter punching in the ribs, easier said than done. And right now, just on him.
Reese is looking, trying to take the back here of Eric Allen. Eric Allen, yeah, turning away, and he's got blood under the left eye already.
Eric Allen looking to flip him over a bit here, but man, not an easy task when you got a gentleman that huge on your back.
Having someone this size on you, even though you're a large size yourself, but having someone this size on you, it's just going to drain energy so quickly out of your small cardio band.
Yeah. I mean, if you think about it, fighters at that weight are carrying that much weight. Yeah. So it's that much more.
That's why you don't see the larger fighters having the cardio and the staying power those lighter weights have.
Plus, having a cup weight is not that difficult.
Yeah, you're at weight class.
But there's advantages and disadvantages because you could be 220 and your opponent's like 250.
You know, for the super heavyweight, oh man.
Eric Allen turned this around though in a big way because Tyler Reese.
Yeah, he is punishing Reese. And Reese is getting back up. I'm not taking this no more. But man, he is doing an old school choke there. Let me guide my hand with my other hand there.
Oh, this is going to turn into a barn burner, and has.
Yes. Reese, still coming back into major heavy leather being thrown right now.
And I'll tell you what, Reese just sticks his chin up in the air. Something I do not advise my fighters to do, but he's walking up there. When he gets hit, he sticks his chin up in the air. Like, bring it on.
That was pretty gangster, I have to say. Very gangster. Love it. Both these super heavyweights put on a show, and this is the loudest the audience has been so far. They're liking what they're seeing.
This is what you want to see with super heavyweights, man.
Yeah. Let's take a look at the replay here, some of the highlights. Seth Reese just coming in. Closes the gap here, throws a couple shots in zone.
And it's scrambling here. That's where he's almost taking the back of Eric Allen. Here he is on the back of Eric Allen, trying to get the choke. Doesn't get it. Inevitably, Eric Allen switches the position. Is it on top? Landing those big, big strikes on Kyla Reese.
Oh man, some more shots being delivered. One after another.
And Kyla Reese throws his hands up like, what? What?
Yeah.
What are you gonna do to me?
Yeah. And off into round two.
I believe Eric Allen said, I will punish you again. What are you doing?
Yeah, that Eric Allen holding on to the neck of Reese and punching him was classic. That's how I used to get bullied. Give me your lunch money. Their hands against my neck.
And again, Kyla Reese just sticking his chin up in the air.
Oh, man.
What?
It's just one punch, but we talk about that one punch from a heavyweight, but these guys have thrown several of those, which just shows the kind of chin that these guys have.
Yeah, much props, much respect for the toughness of these two gentlemen.
Eric takes it to the ground. He says, dude, I am not going to risk this no more. It almost looks like he was ending up in a crucifix here. Started to.
That is something I like. It tells you the skill of other fighters. Is when you kick someone to the ground, the ease of which you do it, some fighters work so hard and blast so much energy just trying to get the takedown, and when they get there, they don't do much. Whereas Eric Allen, he just executed a perfect textbook takedown and has given him the power to keep that going forward against this Kyla Reese.
And you see him how he pulled his arm back there just to get a couple shots in. There we go. Just on him.
This is big man on big man.
Reese taking a couple shots from underneath.
This one, I think we can call big man on big man fun.
Yeah. We all know the majority of those underhand shots while they're on the ground are going to land on the chin if they do land.
Blood is now flowing from Kyla Reese. I was trying to figure out who that's coming from. It looks like a good amount of blood dripping out here. I believe it's coming from the nose.
And Eric Allen is taking his back once again.
Doing a great job of making him carry his weight. I preach this to my fighters, and I love him standing up and throwing the knee strikes to the body. I don't care what you say to the other fighters, saying, oh, it don't hurt, it don't hurt. But these do hurt and take a lot out of you.
Yes,
these knee strikes that Eric Allen is throwing are very heavy.
I like to call that the fighter superman. You know what I mean? He has something to take home with him during this fight. If you can't remember it.
Cecil's looking to step in. It looks like he stopped his fight. With 18 seconds left, let's see if Tyler can run into the score.
Yeah, I mean, going into the next round, it's still going to be a disadvantage after taking all those shots. Man. So I guess a back to the head here thing. And that would just conclude that round. And now he's holding onto the ankle too as if he was holding onto the arm. And Allen just was on top of him the entire time. Not letting up. One shot to the back of the head didn't really hit, but some people can stop it right then and there. And a quick look at our cage rules. You can see more of them at kingofthecage.com.
This is the third and final round.
And you can hear the fans. They are really cheering these guys on. They're throwing a lot on the line here.
Last 3 minute round here between these two.
Oh man. I can't remember the last time I've seen super heavyweights go past the second. Let alone be in the third round here.
And throwing heavy shots and landing them.
Yeah, it's like these guys are non-stop.
They hate their lightweights. I don't know what's going on with these guys.
Yeah.
I think it's opposite there.
Yeah, it is. These guys are just absolutely throwing all on the line.
Usually you only see this in the lighter weights where you see guys landing big shots and continuing, but not in the super heavyweight division.
With a big hook.
Wow.
Eric Allen just like that, and that's the hit we're talking about. So soft, but I guarantee that's like a bag of bats.
Yes, that is. And that hit right on the button. Eric Allen is still dazed in the middle of that cage.
I mean, that first tap probably set it up there. Oh,
right on the jaw. And one to finish it. One to make sure the bet is made.
Yeah. One to make sure Jason is gone. You know what I mean? Jason Voorhees.
Yes.
These guys kept coming around. There's another look at an angle there.
Well, man, just an excellent fight. Eric Allen lost, but, you know, you got it. It's just how it happens, you know. Someone's got to win.
Time, 43 seconds of the third and final round. Your winner by knockout from the land of Lincoln, Tyler Bryant Reese.
Well, the super heavyweights putting on a great show here tonight, and these